أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله والحمد لله والصلاة والسلام على رسول الله. All praise is due to Allah and may His peace and blessings be upon our beloved Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. To all of our viewers, assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuhu. May the peace and blessings of Allah be upon all of you, and thank you for joining us again here in lifting your shackles and liberating yourself. We have been talking about a physical sort of a shackle, and we're talking about diseases especially. And today we are going to speak about an important issue, I believe, that needs our attention, especially the attention of the Muslim community. We're talking about diseases that are self-inflicted, diseases that could have been prevented, yet somehow, be it in a sense of poor diet, poor preventative measures, somehow we bring it upon ourselves. And we will be talking about STDs today, specifically about AIDS. STDs, as you know, is an acronym that stands for sexually transmitted diseases. December 1st is being designated as World AIDS Day. That's when, you know, people speak about AIDS to bring about awareness, to speak about what is being happening, what is being going on, the different sorts of medications, if any, has been discovered about this. At this point, just to bring it to your information, AIDS is an acronym that stands for acquired immune deficiency syndrome. And we will not go into the historical development of the disease, but what we know of it to be, it is a disease that attacks the immune system of a human being, man or woman, anybody. And as a result, the immune system is weakened and it becomes so very vulnerable that other diseases may easily come and cause death or severe ailment by this disease. At this point, every single country is affected, no exception. Whether it be Muslims, non-Muslims, in the West, in the East, South or North, everybody is affected at this point. Just to share with you some of the statistics about AIDS and what is going on with AIDS at this point. 2.9 million people died of AIDS in the year 2003. That is almost 3 million people in 1 year. Nearly 500,000 were children under the age of 15. You're talking about 4.8 million people were newly infected with HIV in 2003. 4.8 million, you know what that means? That translates into 14,000 people every single day. You're talking about, as of the end of 2003, an estimated 37.8 million people around the world were living with AIDS, HIV. 35.7 million adults and 2.1 million children under the age of 15. You're talking about 3 million people losing their lives back in 2003. Almost 500,000 were children under the age of 15. You're talking about 20 million people that have died since the first AIDS case was identified back in 1980. Not only that, but it is expected that 25 million children will be orphaned by 2010 because of AIDS. In the year 2010, by then, 25 million children are going to be living as orphans. As we speak now, about 40 million people are currently living with AIDS. Listen to this. 40 million have already died. 40 million are already living with it. That is almost 10% of the entire population of the entire continent of Africa. If there are 800 million Africans, then 10% of them have either died or they have already the disease or the equivalent of that. And as we said, 14,000 people die or are infected with AIDS every single day. And that is a lot of people. And like we said, you know, within the Muslim community, let's not cheat ourselves. And let's not lie to ourselves. AIDS does not discriminate. It does not tell us who you are, but it tells us what you do. And as such, we are all, you know, we are all exposed to it because of what? Because of what we do. So because you are a Muslim does not mean that you will not get it. It is about a lifestyle. It is about choices that you make. If you make these types of choices, chances are you might end up getting this type of a disease. How is AIDS spread? Well, you look into this and here's what we are told. It is by sharing and sterilized needles, syringes, and other equipments, and other equipments that are used for injection. And that is why, for example, they say that a good number of people who get AIDS are drug users that share needles with other people who are already infected. And remember that the way AIDS moves from a person to another person is either through blood or blood transfusion or kidney or any other body part transplants. You are looking into vaginal fluid. It's mostly bodily fluid that would do this. So these drug users would come in, and again, sadly, it may not necessarily be drug users. It could be, you know, things that we might get exposed to when we are in the hospital. But these syringes and these needles, when they are not sterilized, they may help in the spreading of the disease. You are looking also into blood transfusion with HIV-infected blood or blood products. You're looking into through organ transplants, as we have said, that are infected with HIV. You are looking through artificial insemination with HIV-infected semen, for example, from an affected mother to her baby. It's about 30%. Not necessarily every mother that's carrying a child, she has AIDS. It means that her baby is going to have AIDS. But at this point, the rates are about 30%. And you're looking into AIDS mostly spreads through indiscriminate sexual activity, homosexuality, and drug abuse. These are the things. You are looking into, again, what we have said about it. It's either indiscriminate sexual activity, you're looking into homosexuality, or you're looking into drug use. And when we speak of Islam, we see that Islam speaks about prevention, because prevention is really the best thing to do. قُلْ إِنَّمَا حَرَّمَ رَبِّيَ الْفَوَاحِشَ مَا ظَهَرَ مِنْهَا وَمَا بَطَنَ. Say, indeed, my Lord has forbidden all forms of decency, whether they be public, whether they be private, whether they be concealed, whether they be revealed. The idea is do your best in avoiding all the things that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has declared to be indecent. Allah said to leave them away, stay away from them. So prevention is really the best thing for this. And what we see is that we see disregard to chastity, for example. And when you are looking into sexual immorality, unfortunately the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam spoke about this. And he said that anytime sexual immorality spreads amongst people and they publicize it and they take pride in it, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is going to punish them with ailments and diseases that did not exist in the people that came before them. But again, we're talking about prevention here, especially with a disease like AIDS. You're talking about some countries, for example, where sadly, children at a very young age, you know, the millions of children that are going to be orphans. The father becomes infected or the mother becomes infected. Children at the age of 9, 10 or 11 years of age now have to take the role of adults where they have to care for their parents. And, you know, naturally the parents have to care for the children until they are of age. But then at that point, even these children have absolutely no skills. They have not had enough education. So what they do is, the only thing that they can do is have somebody else misuse and abuse their body by becoming and going into the path of prostitution. That is why you get them by the age of 13, 14, and 15. They themselves at this point are being infected with HIV and AIDS. And this ugly cycle just keeps rolling and rolling, and as like a snowball. The further it goes down, the bigger it is getting. You're talking about schools that have closed down because the teachers have gotten sick. And what they do is the teacher can no longer come to the classroom. They end up moving the classroom with merge them with another bigger classroom, which means that no student understands, because the population of the students in one classroom, because of lack of teachers, so the students have no teachers to teach them. And as a result, it is closed down as well. You talk about poverty, where people are already poor, and then the parents are no longer working, so they become poorer because now they have nobody to work for them. The parents die, the grandparents move in, or the parents get sick, the grandparents move in, and what you have is now there is no income, and the people in the household, they have increased. And what you see going on is that, again, poverty, poor people are becoming poorer, sick people are becoming sicker in areas where ignorance prevails. There is more ignorance as a result, and as a result, you see this truly, truly as a shackle. Obviously, this episode is not enough to discuss such an issue of AIDS, but inshallah, this was an introduction, and we will continue with this again, inshallah, when we meet in the next episode. Thank you for joining us at this point, and inshallah, we hope that you join us again when we meet next time. Until then, we say so long, and assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.